Hello, I'm Beresford Skelton. I'm a member of the Company of Mission Priests, which is a dispersed community of priests in the Church of England. We were formed in 1940 and have consecrated our lives to the mission of the Church, living and encouraging each other with mutual prayer and fellowship, and following in the footsteps of St. Vincent de Paul, the sacrificial priesthood dedicated to serve all. I've been ordained 43 years and have served 33 of those years here in the parish of St. Mary Magdalene Millfield and 16 years united with the parish of the Good Shepherd on the Ford Estate here in Sunderland. First of all, I want to say what a privilege and an honour it is for me to be present at that gathering in January. Our little band of brothers, the Company of Mission Priests, only 80 years old, to be recognised and valued by the Vincentian family was a great boost of confidence for us as we endeavour to live our lives in Vincentian charism. It's appropriate for me to contemplate Sister Blandine's What We Have Heard, and this week I want to think about the parable of the sower and the seed. The quantity of seed, where the seed's sown, what fruit it will bear are all unknown. But the seed is the word of God, and the word was made flesh in the womb of Mary, whose feast we keep today, Our Lady of Mount Carmel. And it was later he said, "And as you did it to the least of one of these, you did it to my brethren." So our mission, what we have been put in our place and in our time to do as Vincentians for God, is to let everyone know that God is beside us in whatever state of our being. I came home with a message for my brothers in the Company of Mission Priests of collaboration and communication for the future, that we must be and can be more enterprising in our portrayal of Christ to others. We must be more and more open in our sharing and working together in our communities so that others would feel that they want to come and join us in our life in Christ, and so keep the charism of St. Vincent afresh in our hearts, our minds and our lives. I came home to CMP and my two parishes here in Sunderland with the words of Father Bob Maloney, CM, quoted by Sister Blandy. Is CMP doing of God's calling? Are we able to read the signs of the times? Does our work bring hope to those around us, open our hope to all around us? Thirdly, what is it that marks us out as unique and different from anybody else who's doing the same work? I remembered words spoken by Father Gregory Gray, CM, a superior general, when he came to visit our annual chapter. He reminded us that our history has made us who we are and what we are, and that we must take that history, make it uniquely our own, and then within the family of St. Vincent, we will be shown how best to use our ministries with every tool and available aid to make the message of Christ's love known to all. The bottom line is that there must be better communication, better use of the resources and resources of the wider Vincentian family. There needs to be a greater sharing of these resources. I am deeply aware that the company has done little to feed its resources into FamVin, and indeed the company itself has done very little to avail ourselves of the great wealth of resources that FamVin have for us. This must change. We need to do more in collaboration that is helpful and helps us and all to live our aspirations of our founders, be it St. Vincent de Paul or Louise de Marillac in the Roman Catholic Communion of Saints, or Father Stephen Beedale of the Society of the Sacred Mission, and Father Ralph Bell of the Community of the Resurrection, and Father Percy Wigram of the Society of St. John the Evangelist, and their confreres in the Holy Men of God in the Church of England, who wanted men to consecrate themselves anew to the ministry of the Church in the Company of Mission Priests, to quote our Constitution and our annual declaration. Sister Blandine pointed out it is essential that the charism be passed on to the next generation, and indeed to the generation after that, with joy that our forebears passed it on to us. We must continue to love our world and to work in our world for Christ's sake, and share the holy joy of holy living in our congregations, our communities, our companies. We must be welcoming, opening with enthusiasm, because enthusiasm makes our charism catch Like faith, the charism is caught, not taught, and we must learn to listen with open minds and open hearts and a loving heart. All this is vital if we are to pass on the rich heritage of the gospel that we have received. It's not about being nostalgic, but rather learning from history, something that the world seems impossible to finds impossible to do. The present moment is always our moment of discernment, our moment for ourselves, that we may value our heritage, the gospel, and pass it on into the future generations. Sister Blandine's reflections brought home to me that the Vincentian family is truly a loving family in all its diversity. It is a unity, and it is given to the church to help all see Christ in everybody, everywhere. Since January, we have come to find ourselves living through extraordinary times. Many of us have experienced the newborn horrors of the COVID-19, the world pandemic. And there's always been the elephant in the room for many years, and we have named it recently racial discrimination. COVID-19 has shown us a coming together of people in communities, and particularly in the Vincentian family, helping each other to achieve a greater degree of love in the hearts of our communities. And I pray, and my prayer is, that that flame of love that we have lighted may be kept alive long after COVID-19 is in history. The facing of racial discrimination has shown the world and ourselves in the world as Vincentians that as Christians we see all our brothers and sisters equal in God's eyes, as God's children, everyone therefore having the rights and dignities that are proper to them as human beings, emphasizing that human life, irrespective of color or nationality or gender or belief or cultural background or gender or sexual orientation, has rights and has to be respected. Jesus never made any distinction among people, neither should we as his followers. St. Vincent de Paul reminds us we live in Christ Jesus through the death of Christ Jesus. We must die in Christ Jesus through the life of Christ Jesus. Our life must be hidden in Christ Jesus and filled with Christ Jesus. And in order to die as Christ Jesus, we must live as Christ Jesus. Let us then, he says, work humbly and respectfully. Learning from history, learning from the present, that we need to trust more in God's providence. But God's providence depends on us knowing of it, and also of what we must be able to do in collaboration and communication for our future. I thank God daily that I was privileged to be among so many wonderful people, hear such amazing stories, and be so much a part of the different diversity in the Vincentian family. It was all too brief, a few days, those days in January, but it has been a daily source of reflection and prayer ever since. I'm very conscious that the Company of Mission Priests is one of the tiniest cogs in the working of FAMVIN. And so, as a tiny part of the whole, I ask these two questions of myself, as well as to you, asking you as individuals. First, what can you do in the place that God has put you and in the time that God has put you? What can you do to be more collaborative? And the second question is, how can you personally improve communication among the wider Vincentian family and within your own community? I thank you for listening.